Dear students, welcome to my YouTube channel on the subject Engineering Graphics. In this video, we'll see the solution for Anna University January 2018 afternoon question paper. I am Dr.M.Senthil Kumar. We'll see the first question. Question 1A, construct a hyperbola when the distance between the focus and directrix is 40 mm, the eccentricity is 4 by 3. Also draw tangent and normal to the curve from any point on it. Okay, so here as the first step, you have to draw an axis, a horizontal line, a directrix, a vertical line. Okay, so draw axis CE, horizontal line. Okay, through C draw a vertical line AB, that is called the directrix. With respect to the directrix, you have to mark the focus F, capital F, on the axis such that it is 40 mm away from the directrix. So CF is equal to 40 mm. CF is equal to 40 mm. Then in the question, they have given the eccentricity. The eccentricity is 4 by 3. With respect to this ratio, you have to mark D such that FD divided by DC is equal to 4 by 3. So add the numerator 4 and the denominator 3. 4 plus 3 7. Divide this 40 into 7 parts, 7 equal parts. Then after that, from here mark, measure 3 parts, mark the third point as D. So then CD equal to 3 parts, DF equal to 4 parts. So then the ratio of the eccentricity ratio of 4 by 3 is maintained. Okay, after that with the DS center, draw arc and draw a vertical line. These two will intersect at G. Okay, similarly in the bottom side you will get G1 also. Whatever I say on the upper side, you have to follow the similar thing on the bottom side also, right? Next step, draw line joining CG and extend. Draw line joining CG1 and extend. Okay, so after that, the procedure is a standard procedure. After F, somewhere on the line CE, draw a vertical line. For example, draw a vertical line 1, 1 dash. Then after that, set the compass to 1, 1 dash with 1, 1 dash as radius. Always F as center. Cut arc on the same vertical line. Okay, similarly on the bottom side also. That way you obtain the cut point 1, 1. Follow a similar kind of procedure by drawing lines, vertical lines through 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and all. Measure the, set the compass to 2, 2 dash with FS center, cut arc and get 2, 1 and so on. Now after getting all the points like this, join all the points and connect D and join all the cutting points in the bottom side also. Thereby you will be completing the profile. The profile obtained here is a hyperbola. So that portion is over now. Then we'll see how to draw a tangent and normal to the curve on a point P on the curve. Point, mark point P somewhere on the curve. Next step, join P with F, the focus focal point. Then draw line through F which is perpendicular to PF, that thereby you'll be getting the intercept on the directrix AB. Mark that as Q. Now draw line joining QP, PQ, that is the required tangent. Okay, here I showed only the tangent, I did not show the normal. The normal is mutually line perpendicular to the tangent. Okay, using a minute after scale, align 1 minute after scale with PQ. Using the other scale, draw, if you draw a line, that is a normal. Okay, so this is the answer for this particular question. We'll see the next problem. 1B, draw the elevation, top view, side view, either left side view or right side view, choice is yours. For the component given below. So this is the object given to you. Okay, so I need not explain much. Now in my next slide, I'll be showing both this question diagram, the solid model of it, and the three different orthographic views: elevation, plan and side view, right? So it is a self-explanatory one. Okay, so this is the question given question to you. Then this is the solid model that I made for you. Then front, this is the front view, top view and the right side view. Okay, so show all the hidden edges by using thick dashed line type. One thing, only one thing you should keep in mind, I have drawn using CAD software, but you have to draw this by freehand proportionately. That is the only difference. Okay, pause the video, see the question solid model, then refer, check with the answer. You will understand more about this particular problem. Okay, now we move on to the next one. Next question, 1 2a. Hexagonal plate of side 20 mm rest on HP on one of its sides inclined at 45 degrees to VP. The surface of the plate makes an angle of 30 degrees with HP. Draw the front view and top view of the plate. Okay, the same question has been asked in Anna University January 2018 in forenoon. Okay, again the same question has been repeated even in this afternoon question paper. Okay, you just see the previous video. Okay, the Anna University January 2018 forenoon FN. So then you will get to know the solution for this particular one. Okay, anyway, we'll see that. The first step, draw the hexagon one side perpendicular to XY. Okay, now draw the corresponding front view. Then you tilt it. Instead of considering the 45 degrees with respect to VP first, consider the 30 degrees with respect to HP first. With respect to 30, using this, tilt the initial front view. This is the second front view now after tilting. Incline at an angle 30 degrees with respect to HP. Draw projectors horizontal lines. That way you can complete the second top view. Now you have to tilt this second top view such that this resting base as resting edge, resting side, which is resting on the HP, is inclined at 45 degrees to VP. Now it is vertical, 90 degrees inclined. Okay, you have to make it incline at an angle of 45 degrees with respect to XY or with respect to VP. So draw a 45 degree line on it, mark F1, A1. With respect to this, complete the third and final top view. Draw projectors, horizontal lines, thereby you can complete the final third and final front view. Here you see again the side or the edge A1 dash F1 dash is on XY, is on HP. We'll see the next question, 2b. The point A of a line AB is in HP and 60 mm in front of VP. The point B is in VP and 40 mm above HP. The distance between projectors is 70 mm. Draw the projections of the line, find the true length, true inclination, and locate its traces. Okay, we'll see. This is the question. It is a kind of a problem. Line inclined to both HP and VP such that one end is in HP and the other end is in VP. First we see, read the problem now. Draw XY line, read the problem. Point A of the line AB is in HP. Point A is in HP and 60 in front of VP. Mark A dash on XY, A 60 degrees below XY, 60 mm below XY, 60 in front of VP. After that, use this statement. The distance between projector is 70 mm. Draw another vertical line which is offset at a offset as a distance of 70 mm from the projector passing through A and A dash. So this is the offset line B dash B. Draw this line first, then only you can mark B dash and B. Okay, so the distance between, horizontal distance between this projector and this vertical line must be 70. That has been given in the question. Distance between projector is 70 mm. On it, mark the point B, which is in VP. So B in VP, its corresponding front view B dash is 40 above HP. So mark B dash on this projector, which is 40 above HP. So now you obtained A dash A, B dash B straight away. So if you join A dash B dash, that is the front view straight away. AB top view straight away. Then you have to follow a reverse procedure. Maybe starting from the top view side. Now top view AB is inclined. Rotate and make it parallel. Now AB1 is parallel to XY. That means the corresponding front view will show the preliminary, it is called the preliminary front view, and that shows the true length and true angle theta. Okay. So after rotating it through B1, draw a projector till cuts the locus passing through B dash at B1 dash. Draw line joining A dash B1 dash. That is the preliminary front view that shows the true line. Measure it and mark here. true length is equal to 100 mm and measure the angle theta, this is theta, the theta is 33 degrees. Then from the front view side, the front view A dash B dash is inclined, rotate and make it parallel. Okay, so then the corresponding top view is called preliminary top view. Now this point after rotating, this point is B2 dash as well as B2. Okay, now draw line joining A, B2, that is again, that must show true length. Measure its angle, it is equal to 37 degree, measure, mark it. So the portion is over and locate its traces. I did not mark the traces here, but anyway, please note down. The procedure for horizontal traces, extend the front view till it cuts XY. Already point A dash is on XY already. So this A dash point itself can be called H dash. Okay, so A dash comma H dash. Next step, from H dash draw a projector till it gets the top view. Now this point is A as well as HT. This is the horizontal trace. Okay, so A dash is A dash comma H dash. The A is HT as well. Similarly, for the vertical trace, you have to extend the top view till it cuts XY. Now B point B is already on XY. So this point itself can be called B comma V. Through V, draw a projector till it cuts the front view. So this point is nothing but B dash as well as this is the vertical trace. So this is the answer for this particular question, right? We'll see the next problem. A cone of base diameter 50 mm and 60 mm axis 60 mm has one of its generators in VP. Draw the projectors when the apex is 35 mm above the HP. So this is the question. You have to draw the circle, base circle in front view such that the center O dash, actually not the center, the apex O dash is 35 mm above HP. So this 35 mm above HP. With respect to the now the O dash, apex point O or O dash is 35 mm above HP. With O dash as center, 25 mm as radius, draw a circle. Then show all the generators. Draw projectors and get the corresponding top view. Now you have to tilt the top view such that one extreme generator OE is on XY. With respect to this, complete the final top view. Draw projectors, horizontal lines, get all the 8 points of the base in top view. Front view. To get this front view, the observer has to see this from this end. For this observer, this position is visible. Okay, this base is completely visible. Okay, so draw an arc joining all the 8 points by freehand in a single stroke. Okay, that completes the base in final front view. Then through O1 dash, draw tangent generators. That completes the problem. You need not draw and show the intermediate generators. Okay. We'll see the next problem. 3P. A cylinder of diameter 30 mm and axis length 50 mm. It is resting on HP on one of the points so that its axis is inclined at 45 degrees to HP and parallel to VP. If we say 45 degrees to HP, if we say the axis is inclined at 45 degrees to HP, the base is inclined at 90 minus 45, again it is again 45. Okay, so this is the answer. Draw a circle in top view, the corresponding front view also you draw. Now you have to tilt the cylinder in front view such that the base is inclined at 90 minus this 45. 90 minus 45 is again a 45. Okay, after drawing the base as a line in final front view, complete this, that completes the thereby you will be completing the final front view. Draw projectors, draw horizontal lines, get 8 points for the top face, 8 points for the base also. To get this final top view, the observer has to see this front view from this position. Okay, so for this observer, the top face is completely visible, the base only 50% is visible, the boundary profile is visible. This portion show it by dashed line and show only the extreme generator, don't darken the in-between generator. Both for cone as well as cylinder, don't darken the intermediate generators. you have to show only the extreme boundary generators or tangent generators, right? This is the answer. We'll see the next question. 4a, a pentagonal pyramid side of base 30 mm and axis 90 mm long is resting on its base with one of its base edges parallel nearer and 15 mm away from the VB. It is cut by a plane perpendicular to HP inclined at 40 degrees to VP and 10 mm away from the axis. Draw the views and also obtain the true shape of the section. So initially you have to draw the projection of the pentagonal pyramid. Okay, pentagonal pyramid side of base, resting on its base with one of the base edges parallel. Okay, the base is on the ground. That means you have to start from the top view. So this is the question. In top view, draw the pentagon such that one of the base edges parallel. That means this edge, base edge ED or DE is parallel to XY. I forgot to mention the distance between XY and this edge, but it has been given as 15 mm away from the VP. Okay, so the base edge ED is parallel to VP, 15 mm in front of VP. So this distance is 15 mm. Show that. Okay, so that completes the problem. Then it is a pyramid, so you have to show the apex in top view also. If you draw two median lines, you can get the O. Then show all the five slant edges. Then with respect to this, complete the corresponding front view. Now introduce a cutting plane. The cutting plane is perpendicular to HP. That means it is seen as a line in top view. So before drawing that, first of all, you have to draw a R10 circle with O as center. Draw R10 circle. Then set the mini drafter scale at an angle of 40 degrees to 40 degrees. Then you move the mini drafter scale and just touch the R10 circle, and that means it should be tangent, right? Touching means tangent. Then draw this cutting plane as a line. It cuts two slant edges and the base. Two on the cutting points on edges, slant edges, and two at the base. There are four cutting points. Four cutting points. Okay, now transfer draw projectors and get all the four cutting points in front view. Join all those and hash the area. That completes the sectional front view. Okay, then for true shape of the section, parallel to this cutting plane as line in top view, parallel to the draw x1 y1, then draw projectors or draw lines parallel to perpendicular to x1 y1. On it mark the points 1 2 1 1 2 1 3 1 4 1, etc. For example, 1 1 and 4 1 are on the base in front view, so the 1 1 and 4 1 must be on x1 y1. To mark, to get 2 1 here, take the height of 2' from xy with this as radius, cut arc on this with respect to x1 y1. Follow the same for 3 1 also. Hash this area. That completes the true shape of the section as well. Okay, now we move on to the next question. 4b, a vertical chimney of 60 meter base diameter joins a roof sloping at an angle of 35 degrees with the horizontal. The shortest portion over the roof is 25 meters. Determine the shape of the sheet metal from which the chimney can be fabricated. Take appropriate scale. Okay, I consider 1 meter as 1 mm here. That is the scale ratio, right? So here in my case, the scale ratio is 1 mm equal to 1 meter, right? So this is the vertical chimney. I have introduced a section plane which is inclined at 35 degrees such that the shortest portion is 25 mm. So like that, you draw the top view and corresponding front view. Now I divided the circle into 12 parts. There are 12 generators, there are 12 cutting points. Okay, by following the parallel line method, draw horizontal lines. Try to get all the 5 cutting points. Then darken the portion remaining. Don't darken the intermediate generators. Okay, darken, show only the end generators or boundary generators. So this is the answer. Okay, the surface, this length is pi d, that is the circumference of the circle. You knew it already. right? If you have any doubt, pause the video, read the problem, then see the answer, correlate the answer with the question. Okay, you will understand in a better way then. We move on to the next question. Draw the perspective view of a square prism of base side 20 mm and height 35 mm, resting on an end on the ground with a rectangular face parallel to the picture plane. The axis of the prism is 25 mm behind the picture plane and 25 mm to the right of the eye. The eye means station point is 50 mm in front of PP and 50 mm above the ground. Okay. Now we will see the answer. Okay, this is a question. Okay, now first step is draw picture plane as a line with respect to PP line. You have to draw the top view. Okay, you read the problem now. A square prism, base side 20 mm, height 35 mm, resting on an end. Okay, prism has got two ends, top face and base. Okay, so the base is on the ground with a rectangular face. This rectangular face is parallel to and 25 mm behind the picture plane. So this vertical plane, it is a vertical face, it is parallel to PP and not this parallel vertical face, the axis, the midpoint of the mid of the square is the axis. Now this axis must be 25 mm to the behind the picture plane. With respect to that, mark the point first. The point is nothing but the axis. With respect to this point, complete this square. The square side of the square is 20 mm. Okay, the side of the square is 20 mm. So mark A, B, C, D, something like that. Okay, the top view is over. The front view. For front view, GP line is the reference. Okay, you have to maintain a convenient distance or gap between PP and GP. The convenience is station point in front and above, sum up 50 plus 50 plus 10 more, 110 maybe. So maintain a gap of 110 mm between PP and GP. Okay, with that distance you draw a GP line, then draw projectors and draw the complete the front view. Okay, here we are following the third angle projection. To get this front view, the observer has to see this top view from the inner side. For this inner side observer, between A and D, A is nearer, that is visible. D is far off, that should be written within bracket. Similarly, B visible, C must be written within bracket. So then C dash within bracket, D dash within bracket. Okay. Then next step. With respect to the given data, draw the central plane. It is seen as a line both in front view and top view, which is 25 mm to the left of the axis. Okay, now on it mark the station point AS. This is small s and this is small s dash, right? So this is 50 in front of PP, 50 above PP. After that, the procedure is very standard procedure. Join all the top view points with S, join all the front view points with S dash. After that, through intercept, draw a projector, get the corresponding points in perspective. For example, to get capital A, so this is the line connecting S. So this is the intercept on P. Through this, draw a projector on it, get A here. This I can call it A1. Okay, A1, right? So follow the similar procedure for the other points B, B1, C, C1, D, D1. Okay, now one more corollary I'll tell you. Now AB is seen as a line. Actually, it is a face. The face size is 20 by 35, the height of the prism. Okay, it is a perfect rectangle in front view. This is the rectangle in front view. The proportionate rectangle only you will be getting even in perspective, because since that rectangle is parallel to PP, okay, you will see the similar kind of rectangle with the same proportion or aspect ratio. Okay, the ratio between the width and height. Okay, the proportion will be same, aspect ratio will be same even for this rectangle, even in perspective. Similarly, for the case of CD, right? So this inner point is hidden, so the the three lines connecting that inner point are hidden. So okay, show and draw those by thick dashed line type. Okay, that completes the problem. We'll see the next question, 5b. A pentagonal pyramid with edge of base 40 mm and axis 70 mm long is resting on its base on HP. One of the base edges of the pyramid is perpendicular to VP. A section plane perpendicular to VP and inclined to HP at 30 degrees passes through the axis at a height of 30 mm from the base. Draw the isometric view of the truncated pyramid. See, it has got three components here. Projection of full solid. The next step, introducing a cutting plane. The next step is going for the isometric. Okay, so I need to explain much about the as per the given data, drawing the full top view and front view. After that, introducing cutting plane, you knew it already, right? It cuts all the five generating points, all five slant edges. Now we'll see about the isometric. To draw the isometric of the base pentagon in pentagon, follow the box method. So put the pentagon inside a box of PQRS. Next step, draw that PQRS box or those edges in isometric, right? Okay, so with respect to that, mark all the points. For example, to mark A, the mark A is actually midpoint of PS. So the capital A must be midpoint of capital PS line. Okay, similarly, follow the similar kind of procedure for B, C, D, and E also. Then comes to the marking, getting the cutting points 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, and 5 dash. Okay, straight away. For that, the method you have to follow is the coordinate method. Okay, for example, let me tell you how to mark, get the 1 dash. Here in top view, the projection of this 1 dash will be falling at this particular point in top view. So in isometric, parallel to PQ through A, draw a line. So parallel through A, you are drawing a line parallel to PQ. On it, you measure this distance of this projection of 1 dash in top view. This distance, measure this distance, okay, with respect to capital A, mark and get that point. That is the 1 1. Okay, that is the projection of the cutting point 1 on the base. Then through 1 1, draw a vertical line whose height is equal to height of 1 dash with respect to xy. That is the procedure for getting the 1. Follow the similar procedure for getting the other points 2. It is not 2 1, 2 2 3 4 5. Now you obtain all the points. Now the cutting profile, section profile is completely visible. So join 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 first. Then darken and show only the visible slant edges and visible base edges. Okay, you need not draw the hidden edges. If at all, if you have drawn, don't darken it, leave it as thin lines. That completes the problem 5b. Okay, so I solved all the 10 problems asked in the Anna University January 2018 afternoon question paper. I hope you have answered all the 5 questions in the examinations correctly. Okay, my best wishes and good luck for your success in this engineering graphics subject. Okay, to all of you, thank you.